إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعله عوجا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله رب العالمين All praises to Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, our scripture, وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بِالْحَقِّ وَيَوْمَ يَقُولُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ قَوْلُهُ الْحَقِّ وَلَهُ الْمُلْكُ يَوْمَ يُنفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ عَلِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ Allah Ta'ala mentions that it is He who has created the heavens and earth. Many of us know people, probably all of us know people, who are affected by the rising tide of atheism in our society, and that's an inevitable outcome of the hegemonic nature of this materialistic civilization. So every day, especially the young people, they get a text message from a friend. I don't know if I believe anymore. I'm not feeling it. I don't know if I'm still a Muslim. And one of the reasons for that is the acceptance of a believer of the materialistic or the premises, accepting the premises of the materialist. So if we start at the very beginning, the materialist says that this creation began with the Big Bang. The believer, there are two premises in this proposition that the believer does not have to hold as being axiomatic as the materialist does. First of all, the materialist assumes that the intensely hot matter that was the stuff of the Big Bang was always there. Or he or she has no explanation for it. So if we ask the question, where did it come from? They have no answer. This is the first axiom the believer doesn't have to accept. That it was always there. We know logically, if it's an effect, it has to have a cause. And the cause of every effect is external to itself. If you see a footprint, you don't assume that the sand just shifted. You assume someone walked on the sand to leave the footprint. If you see a house, you don't assume that the wood and the nails and the glass and the shingles just randomly threw themselves together. You assume there was a builder external to the wood and the nails and the glass that put it all together. The second axiom is that even though it was stable, it was in a stable state, suddenly it exploded. So if we would never accept that if we one moment we looked at a scale and the two plates were balanced, and a minute later one scale was up and one was down, we would never accept that that equilibrium was not disrupted by something placed on one scale. We'd assume someone placed some weight in one scale and it therefore became preponderant over the other. It's stable, the stability, it's in equilibrium, equilibrium is disrupted, there has to be a disruptor. So if there's a big bang, there has to be a big banger. Science has no answer. Where did it come from? There's no answer. Some of you are scientists. I challenge you to give me an answer. How was the stable state disrupted? There's no firm answer. There are theories. There are hypotheses. Give me one that's proven true. Find someone to bring me one that's proven true. The believer says no, and the believer's answer is logical. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. It is He who has created the heavens and earth. Why is it logical? Because Allah is beyond this world. And Allah existed before this world. كَانَ اللَّهَ وَلَا شَيْءَ كَانَ اللَّهُ وَمَا وَلَا شَيْءَ مَعَهُ. Allah was there and there was nothing along with Him. Existing along with Him. He is external to this creation. قَاهِرٌ فَوْقَ عِبَادِ. And He brought it about. عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Science seeks to answer the question of how. How did it happen? Of where? Where did it come from? There's one question science doesn't even ask, let alone answer. And that's the question of why. The question of purpose. And Allah Ta'ala tells us why. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بِالْحَقِّ. He has created it بِالْحَقِّ, meaning with a purpose. He's created it with a purpose. And the greatest purpose that it has is to point out to us, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. أَلَّا فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ آيَةٌ تَدُلَّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاحِدٍ. In everything there's a sign that points to the fact that He is one. And so one of the greatest crises of the atheistic age we're entering into is people lose their sense of purpose. They don't know why they're here. They don't know what this life is all about. They don't know what they're supposed to be doing. The believer has a sense of purpose. Because just as Allah Ta'ala created the heavens and the earth to direct the believer towards Himself. Once the believer is directed towards Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, he or she knows what they're supposed to be doing. وَمَا خَلَقُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I've only created the jinn and the human that they worship me. We're here to worship Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And if you take away the worship of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, that propensity that Allah Ta'ala has put into the human being will leave a void that will be filled by something else. If they don't worship Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, they'll worship themselves. And look at the narcissism we see in our world today. The age of narcissism. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنَ اتَّخَلَ إِلَاهُ هَوَاهُ. Have you not seen the one who's taken himself as his God? The very inclinations of his soul as his God. They'll worship money. They'll worship clothing. The people who shop until they drop. Why are they shopping until they drop? Because there's a void in their soul that they're trying to fill by shopping. And you can worship clothes. Some people worship money. Their every waking moment or their every waking thought is about how they can get more money. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us about the worshipper of money and the worshipper of clothing, and he told us what their fate would be. Taisa abdu dinar wa abdu dirhami wa abdu khamisa. Ruined is the worshipper of gold, the gold coin and the silver coin, money, and the worshipper of the nice tunic, the khamisa. Taisa wa takas. May he be ruined, and the Prophet prayed for him, and it could be a believer. May he be ruined, and if he's pricked by a thorn, may he not find any tweezers to pluck it out. We then shika fanan takash. Tuba li abdin, akhidan bi inayi farasuhu fi sabilillah. Paradise is for the servant who grasps the reins of his steed and goes forth in the way of Allah. In other words, the person who gives themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give yourself to Allah. What are you waiting for? Are you waiting for the time you get rich when that's not guaranteed to anyone? Are you waiting for the time you retire? You're not guaranteed to reach the age of retirement. Are you waiting until you get as big a house as you can get, or as nice a car as you can get, when it's not guaranteed to anyone? Fafiru ila Allah. Flee to Allah right now, brothers and sisters. Give yourself to Allah right now, brothers and sisters. Fulfill the purpose of your creation right now, brothers and sisters. Otherwise, you'll run through the earth, through the world like a wild beast with no purpose, no direction. Because there's no direction and there's no purpose for the human being outside of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no fulfillment for a person outside the worship of Allah, coupled with the service of creation. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You're the best of communities raised up for humanity. Any khidmat in nas, that is to say, to serve the people. Wallahu fi aun al abdi ma kana al abdu fi aun akhihi. Allah Ta'ala will continue to assist the servant as long as the servant is assisting his brother. Now they tell us, don't worship Allah and look out for numero uno. Don't look out for anybody else. Take care of yourself. The economy's bad. Hold on to your money. Forget charity. Altruism is the way of weaklings. If you're a true and strong human being, you look out for yourself and no one else. No one else, right? Atlas shrugged. Or shrugs. The Ayn Rand philosophy of life. Individualism. No altruism. No consideration for others. What kind of world would we have? We'd have a world like the one we're sinking into. Then Allah Ta'ala would tell us, Huwa huwa alladhi khalaqa samawati wal ardi bil haqq. Wa yawm yaqulu kun fayakun. How did he do it? Kun fayakun. Be and it is. Be and it is. قَوْلُهُ الْحَقِّ. His word is true. We can say something, it might be and it might not be. It will only be. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا إِن يَشَاءُ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What you desire will only have effect if it's consistent with what Allah has desired. That's the only effect we have. We say be and it is. Allah says, be and it is. And His word is true. His word is true. قَوْلُهُ الْحَقِّ. So He mentions the physical creation. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِالْحَقِّ. He has created the heavens and the earth. With truth, we can say, and we interpret it with a purpose, but in truth, literally. قَوْلُهُ الْحَقِّ. His word is true. What does this tell us, brothers and sisters? This tells us that everything, both the physical creation, our examination of the physical creation, and the divine commandment, which emanates from the metaphysical realm, right? Revelation is from the world, the realm beyond the physical. It's all true. هو الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق قوله الحق ألا له الخلق والأمر unto Allah is the physical creation and the divine commandment. Tabarakallahu Rabbul Alameen. All praises for Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. It all returns to Allah. It all returns to Allah. And the ancients recognized this. And so they envisioned the physical world existing in harmony with the metaphysical world. It is the moderns who have broken this connection. And we can say the postmoderns. And they've separated the physical world from the metaphysical world. And to make a long story short, they've taken ethics out of science. They've taken ethics out of medicine. They've taken ethics out of politics. And so you get these ideologies. And Muslims fall into them. You get these ideologies that lead to cold-blooded murder. You get science that leads to cold-blooded murder and or the destruction of the environment. You get politics that leads to putting systems in place that justify these growing, gaping disparities between rich and poor. Because ethics have been taken out of politics, and ethics have been taken out of science, and ethics have been taken out of economics. Whereas we understand it's all integrated, and it all goes back to Allah. Alimul ghaybi wa shahada. He knows the seen, the unseen, and the seen. Alimul ghaybi wa shahada. And it's significant that the ghayb is mentioned first. Because this should be more real for us than what we see. It should be more real for the believer. The first description of the believer in the Quran, read as it's arranged. First we read the Fatiha, praise of Allah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. A prayer to Allah, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqeem. Then we read Surah Baqarah, Huda lil Muttaqeen. But there's no description. It is guidance for the righteous. Who are the righteous? The first description, Alladheena yu'minuna bil ghayb. Those who believe in the unseen. Alladheena yu'minuna bil ghayb. Those who believe in the unseen. Wa yuqeemuna as-salata wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqoon. The first description of the believer, those who believe in the unseen. This is a message for us, but it's also a warning for us. Don't become so attached to this physical world that you become a functional materialist. Functional, pray, fast, make the shahada. But the reality of hell and heaven, resurrection, the grave, resting in the grave, the bridge, that will traverse, the angels, all of that becomes something we might intellectualize, but it's not something we believe in the depths of our souls, because we've been so skewed by this materialistic civilization. Allah Ta'ala is telling us this is the first description of the believer, and when this goes, everything else collapses. This is what our forebears recognize. So they gave us the medicine to cure our hearts of its materialism. They gave us the medicine to cure our souls and to keep us connected to the ghayb, to keep it before us as if we could see it. As if we could see it. And when that our hearts are filled with it, the things that Allah Ta'ala, the Messenger of Allah tell us, they take on a new meaning. اتقوا فراسة المؤمن فإنه ينظر بنور الله. Beware of the inner vision of the believer because he sees with the light of Allah. But that's when the heart is cultivated. When Umar radiallahu anhu was on the minbar in Medina, and then he yelled out, يا سارعك الجبل. Saria, the mountain, they're lying in ambush. And they were on the frontier near the Iraqi border. And they heard him. And the army turned back and they avoided the ambush. How did he see that? Binurillah, with the light of Allah. فَإِنَّهُ يَنْظُرُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. That was illuminated in his heart. And where did the illumination came from? It came from getting up for prayer in the middle of the night. It came from reading the Quran with regularity and reflecting and contemplating on his memory. It came from a tongue that was ever moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot give our every waking hour to chasing and involving and plunging deeper and deeper into this materialistic side of reality and expect the fruits of faith in our hearts. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. And that's why so many people, they're turning away from faith because they're doing nothing to nurture and cultivate their faith. And they'll be sorely disappointed. Because at the end of the day, they'll find out just as their body, and they look in the mirror, and they see the wrinkles coming, and they see the physical strength waning, and they can't do what they used to do. They go to try to do it, and they break something, or pull something, or pop something. And then the reality, that just like their bodies, and just like their intellectual power, and just like their joints, كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانٍ. Everything in this physical world is temporal. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانٍ. Don't be deceived by it, brothers and sisters. Attach your heart to Allah. Open your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Engage in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not the remembrance of this world. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ ولسائر المؤمنين يقول مستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وقرة أعيننا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا ما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. All praise is due to Allah who has guided us to this path and we would not have been able to guide ourselves if not Allah guided us. May Allah Ta'ala bless everyone. May Allah Ta'ala bless all of us to get closer to Him. May Allah Ta'ala illuminate our hearts. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala illuminate our minds. May Allah Ta'ala put nur, put light in our hearts. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala lift us above the clutches of the material realm. Not that we rejected it, but we put the ethics back into science, and we put the ethics back into medicine, and we put the ethics back into politics, and we pursue justice. We pursue it. And whether we attain it or not, that's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we never despair. We never despair. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَحْمِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. It is only a disbelieving people that despair of Allah's mercy. Brothers and sisters, never despair. Never let the travails of the times take the smile from your face. Never think the times that you live in are unique in terms of their trials and tribulations. When would you rather live? We live in a wonderful time. Would you rather live as a Muslim when Genghis Khan and his descendants are ripping the Ummah apart? Would you rather live as a European in World War II when 80 some odd million people would perish in that small geographical area? Or World War I in the trenches with the mustard gas? Would you rather live during the age of skepticism? When would you rather live? Here during the Civil War? During a time, you know what the Civil War was, we'll stop here. If you took the almost 6 million people who died during the American Civil War, and you extrapolate it from that number based on today's population, almost 35 million Americans would die. That's what the Civil War was. The whole state of California, every single living soul in California gone from the United States. That's what the Civil War was. Would you rather live then? Would you rather live as a slave during slavery? Some of you saw the movie, 12 Years a Slave, which captured some of the brutality. Would you rather live then? No, this is the time Allah Ta'ala gave us. This is our time, brothers and sisters. Don't curse the darkness, light a candle, as they say. Don't run away from the challenges. Meet them head on. Don't let the smile be taken from your face. Smile in the face of the challenges as you meet them. Smile in the face of the challenges as you meet them, not as you flee from them, as you meet them. Allahumma ghfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal amwat ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا افرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين ربنا افرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وتوفنا مسلمين واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن ونعوذ بك من العجز والكسل ونعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل ونعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال ونعوذ بك من الفقر إلى إليك من الخوف إلى منك من الذل إلا لك اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تعول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا بها جنتك ومن اليقين ما يهون علينا مصاعب الدنيا ومتعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عدانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين واعفو عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين وكونوا مع الصادقين وكونوا مع الصادقين أكمل الصلاة